trooper. It's Sunday. You know, Sunday. Speaking of that, looks like the sun is out. Oh, what do you know? Just like every day in Vegas.
Got all this breeze action going today.
Larry, I hear the music first.
The only time you did right.
72 degrees in the Fahrenheit out there. And, yeah. 1:48 in the PM. Let's head on down to the strippy strip. And, yeah, I need to check something. I think I have a plan for food and coffee today. And poker. An idea for a lovely sandwich to eat before I jump into a poker game. Starbucks on the casino floor at Planet Hollywood got a remodel. Looks completely different. See how much brighter it is? This tastes like shit. Being for thinking, whoa, is that a word? To forethink? Well, being that shit, I called to put my name on the list of Aria. So, what about this concept? Something I just thought up. Imagine if you were forced, some way or another, to only eat dog food. So dog food tastes pretty disgusting to most humans. But imagine for a moment that you were forced to eat dog food. That's all you had access to. You either eat dog food or die. But what if you had the mentality where you were like, you know what? If I'm gonna have to eat dog food, then I might as well take the attitude that dog food is awesome. I love dog food. This shit is so good. I'm having the time of my life eating this dog food, right? That's the way I feel about certain things in pop culture, right? Like maybe certain types of music, or maybe certain types of fashion, or maybe certain people who are just there for you to look at. An example would be the Kardashians. That is kind of like dog food, in my opinion. But here's the problem. No one's forcing people to like that shit. Or are they? Maybe they're being forced by pop culture itself. Or maybe peer pressure. Interesting thing to think about on the walk today. I don't like dog food. I'm not gonna pretend that dog food is, fun to eat. I'm just not gonna do it. one of the worst dealers that I've encountered in all of Vegas works at Aria. So he came to my table and I had just played the big blind. But somewhere between that, him sitting down, and my under the gun hand, I had king queen. I guess it was like under the gun plus three. So whatever you want to call that, nine handed. I raised to 12 with king queen. Dude on my left calls. Dude on his left calls. And the small blind proceeds to put out $3. And the dealer's just staring at it like he's in outer space. Like, hello, wake up. Is there anybody here that could run this game? So they get it fixed. He calls the 12, the big blind calls the 12. The flop is ace, queen, 10, and somehow I bet 30 on the flop and take it down. But he's just one of the, and by the way, I almost didn't tip him because he's so bad. He sucks so bad. He's so apathetic. But I did. Because I leaned in the direction of tipping if I'm not sure if I want to or not. Dude didn't say a word. Picked it up, put it in his pocket. When I was a dealer, I said thank you to every single tip. I didn't stop and pause for a second and make eye contact and say, thank you, sir, very much. I just simply said thank you. Click, click, put it in the thing, and then you're off. It's one of my pet peeves. Dealers that don't say thank you. Speaking of coffee, recently at home I've been drinking some coffee that is somewhere around 512 times better than any Starbucks I've ever had, including my favorite Starbucks coffee, which is Casi Cielo, which is a Guatemalan coffee. The stuff I've been drinking at home lately, which you'll find out about soon, is about 512 times better. By the way, I failed to report earlier that the French dip from Earl of Sandwich was sort of good. The weird thing is the onions, I like grilled onions, I like cooked onions, but something was weird about the onions. They had a weird taste, they weren't good. The onions weren't good. And I liked the sandwich on that toasty bread that they make at Earl of Sandwich with the au jus, but the onions brought the flavor of the sandwich way down. They were like, what's the word I'm looking for? You know when you cook garlic too long? And it gets that bitter flavor. It was kind of like that. Say what's up to Herb from New Brunswick. That's in Canada, right?
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah.
Go gamble.
There you go.
Responsibly.
Yeah, that. I should put that on the hats. Always say, oh yeah, well I would like to tell you an interesting hand, but nothing interesting happened in the game. When I say that, I'm saying it from my perspective. From the perspective of someone who's played like poker every day for a long time, right? This guy has his entire hand down the front of his pants. The guy way back there in the background has entire hand down the front of his pants. Oh Lord. Yo, shout out to Chris and wife that I just ran into there at the Burger Lounge. I went back to be like, do you want to be in the vlog? Say hello to the vlog, but you were gone. My bad. You probably didn't care, you would have said something. Thanks for getting that hat. And thanks for watching my videos. Well, Sunday night, I'm over it. And something weird happened with my cash out. Yesterday, I bought in for $400. And I cashed out for $430. If you remember, I said I won $30. So today, I bought in for $400 and I cashed out for $430. So the exact same buy-in and the exact same cash out. Also interesting enough, yesterday I was down 95 at one point, and today I was down about 105 at one point. Just weird. Anyway, I won $30. What can I do? It's the Poker Go Studio. What? Wind is going. Zoltar's punk ass.
Gonna tell me my damn fortune. Not up in here. Not up in here.
Whoa. Yo, remember, if you like my videos, click the thumbs up button. Make sure you subscribe. Tell your friends about the videos and leave a comment down below. And if you don't like it, suck it. I'll see you next time.